Dr. Javier Suarez and Dr. Miguel Gomez are joining us for the installation of this event, which is the most important academic event of insurers here in Colombia this year. The dynamics of the world oblige us to do it online. Good morning. A special and warm greeting to the people joining us on this occasion. And thank you, President of the Republic, Dr. Iván Duque Márquez, for being present. Thanks to Drs. Alberto Carrasquilla, Minister of Finance and Public Trade, Dr. Gerardo Hernández, Co-Director of Bank of the Republic, Dr. Jorge Castaño, Financial Superintendent of Colombia, our speakers, national and international representatives of the insurance and reinsurance companies, and all those persons who, from their different roles, are part of the insurance sector that honor us with their participation during this event. Some are present from this very moment, and others will join in later. Our special thanks to all of you for joining us. I speak to you as a president of the Board of Directors of Asecolda to kick off this International Convention of Insurance. And on this occasion, it is carried out, as we all know, in an online fashion. The simple fact that this year we are carrying out this convention online shows us that from the very beginning, that many of the challenges that we have as a consequence of the pandemic of COVID-19, all of us have had to face. And of course, the insurance sector has not been foreign to. There have been months of many challenges in different senses, and the insurance industry is one of the sectors that has had many opportunities to show the reason for being. We highlight the economic efforts that companies have had to make to honor their commitments as insurance companies, as well as by having to deploy actions to take care of the reputation of the industry. Let's remember then some figures related to the pandemic. At the end of September, the number of people affected by COVID-19 overcame the 30 million persons in the world. From that universe, the data account for many deaths because of this. These figures show the delicate public health that are faced by all the countries around the world. And despite the measures taken, the absolute number of registered cases, Colombia ranks fifth after the United States, India, Brazil, Russia, and Peru. However, we have to be prudent in the interpretation of these figures because of the difference of the clarity of register of the deaths. What is evident is that before the limited capacity of our hospital network to face a challenge of the size that we have at hand, it was important to take drastic measures that will allow us to stop the pandemic or limit it while we adapted the network of hospitals to avoid the peak of this. The active decision of the government and local governments in the face of the situation that has been unedited allowed to avoid what would have most likely been a collapse to stop this with a catastrophic impact in the mortality registered during these circumstances in other countries. The consequences of the pandemic on an economic level have been severe. According to DANE, the economy fell in the third quarter 15.7%, the highest figure that there is record of in our history. Unemployment of the 13 biggest cities around the country on their end increased to 24.3% in the second quarter. This represents 13.2% higher than the unemployment observed in the same quarter of last year. The high informality existing in our workplace, the need to support companies in critical circumstances, and the lack of hospital infrastructure to address this emergency obliged the government to start relief programs and support in these areas. Programs such as Agroingreso Solidario, the program to formal employment, the capitalization of the National Guarantees Fund, and the improvement of the infrastructure of health will mint extraordinary egresses for close to 25 billion pesos, which adds to the drop of collection due to economic recession. Under these circumstances, the fiscal deficit will move from 2.2% estimated for this year to 8.2%, and the level of debt from 52% of the GDP to 65% or more. To the extent that the hospital capacity has been strengthened, where there has been an implementation of measures all over the world, and that the virus has extended, reducing the probability of contagion, economies have been able to open up once again, and the economic activity starts to rebirth. The GDS checked their objectives at the beginning of September, moderating the size of the drop, while in June, the OECD thought that the would fall from less than 6%. The new projection drops to a drop of 4%. For 2020, it is expected to have a growth of GDP of 5%. Even though the uncertainty continues being big, the estimations believe that the Colombian will drop between 6 and 7% in 2020, and that in 2021, there will be a recovery between 4.5 and 5.5%. We have to be clear that achieving the levels of the product that we had in 2019 will take us close to 3 years, and to reach the product that we would have achieved in absence of COVID-19, between 5 and 7 years. In the economic front, we share the change of pace in the national rhythm when compared to the isolation measures that allow us to recover the economic activity affected during the past months. It is necessary to leave behind the debate between health and economy and to recognize that both are intimately linked to each other, and that an economy severely affects the well-being of citizens, specifically those who are in informality and those low social economic levels that feel the economic and health effects in a much more severe way. That is exactly where the insurance companies play a very important role, accompanying the reactivation of close to 10 million workers that work for companies affiliated to the work risk system, and that to the extent that they go back to their work, it will reduce the size of the economic damage caused. At the same time, it is noticeable to see the positive impact that in this situation has been generated by the insurance company with a purpose to keep the entrepreneurial tissue by unemployment insurance and rent insurance. Now, this situation that has effects worldwide brings the insurance company a great opportunity, so that in a hard way, we can bring down the wrong perceptions that people have on insurance and insurance companies, to change the notion of small letters as a synonym of a tricky activity is imperative. And this is how it is necessary to continue showing with facts and figures the true value of our insurance activity in functioning as a support to risks, as enabler of entrepreneurship and innovation, as a catalyst event for the generation of employment, and in the creation of a much more resilient society. We are before the most ambitious projects in our country, such as the construction of the important infrastructure works, hospitals and airports. We support the realization of professional activities such as medicine, administration, engineering, the same as contracting before private parties and between the government and its contractors. Our activity represents an activity not only to the government, but also to micro companies and middle-sized companies, entrepreneurs that with their bravery, good ideas, and small capitals will provide their services, and they build services for our society by generating employment, growing and strengthening over time. We also safeguard the people by offering them a network of protection for their equity in such a way that they don't lose it in case of an event of a catastrophic event like the one that we are facing. We offer protection to the families in case any of their members are missing. Without the insurance, the potential costs associated to the manifestation of a number of risks would establish a setback, and it would make it unfeasible. We are not an activity that is foreign to our customers, that are indolent to their needs or empathetic. On the contrary, we work every day to join them, to support them, to learn about their needs, to offer the products by way of innovation, and all of that under the framework of free competition for the benefit of society. Our commitment is supported by figures. To December of last year, the sector paid sinisters of 15.3 billion pesos to hundreds of natural persons and legal persons. They offered protection to over 1.5 million of house owners, to over 2 million vehicle owners in the mandatory insurance and 8 million to SOAT. We also offer protection to over 9.5 million workers and close to 950,000 companies that are affiliated to the general work risk sector that carry out their activities in different sectors of the economy. It is important to mention that only do we not benefit the society and the clients, but we value and protect our most precious equity, who are our collaborators. They are part of our teamwork, and we have close to 16,700 persons, of which 63% are women, and 33,000 intermediaries work with us. It is close to 50,000 persons and their families who have been positively affected in their lives by being involved in this noble activity. A majority of us who are here understand the value of insurance. It is time that more people are benefited and learn about this, not only in terms of the quality of customers, but also from the viewpoint of other persons who are part of different interest groups, such as representatives of government, of Congress, judicial branch, the media, among others. We also recognize the complexity of the current situation. We recognize the hard situation that many people are facing and others that unfortunately are still continuing to face difficult moments. From the insurance sector, we have to be supportive and we have to make our contribution with a social context that has characterized our activity in the past decades. I would like to mention two elements that are becoming evident at this level of our fight against this pandemic. The first one has to do with a positive response offered by the insurance company or industry to their customers, vendors, collaborators, and intermediaries. The second is related to the huge opportunity offered by this adversity to boost substantial changes in the way as to how we have developed our activity. At the beginning of confinement, all of our sector, recognizing that the insurance has a reason for being in assuming risks, we sought to pay attention and provide services to claimants, and we focused on mechanisms for alternate communications to keep in touch with the different stakeholders, especially their clients, to respond to their needs in the moment when they needed it our support the most. In a moment like the one we are currently facing, where risks have become materialized, it is the moment that the insurance sector can and should show the sense and scope of insurance. This is how we did it, and this enlightens or highlights our view. So we created protocols for the attention and evaluation of damage claims in almost all the different branches to migrate them to an online format. We transformed products and recreated our services for customers. The companies were transformed to operate almost online entirely, adapting the information systems so that these could be operated from the households of our collaborators. And at the same time, this allowed us to take care of our workers. The list of actions taken during this stage of the situation is extensive and with elements of great value for our groups of interest. The way as to how the sector adapted is amazing to respond to the needs of their customers and other groups of interest in this time of crisis. It is timely to reiterate the important role that the insurance companies acting as work have affected in this pandemic. ARLs were summoned to address the needs of professionals in health by way of the provision of personal protection equipment. With huge logistic difficulties in the face of an obligation that appeared all of a sudden, and by facing a global race for the acquisition of these elements, the insurance sector has been meeting and fulfilling the needs of the health professionals. It has been over 40 million personal protection elements delivered from the beginning of the pandemic. And now, beyond the delivery of these personal protection elements already mentioned, the ARLs, in a committed fashion, seeking to positively affect the pandemic, protected and are still protecting workers, health workers, their affiliating companies, aiming their efforts also to being partners of the government containing this pandemic and the adequate handling of this pandemic. As a guild, we had the opportunity to work in a coordinated fashion very closely with the Ministry of Health and the financial superintendents, seeking to find, along with authorities, convergence points to trace the adequate paths that will allow us to contribute to the care of Colombians' health. On another note, it is important to remember that all adversities has an opportunity along with it. An important part of this transformation that we had to face as an industry in this time of crisis has become in a final push that we needed to get closer to the new insurance consumer, to understand that there were new models to commercialize our products and other ways of operating, different ways of interacting, and other ways of being productive. We have been forced to think outside the traditional paradigms and launched to the creating, innovating, and generating value in a very different way. Within these important challenges, we have the imperious need of having simpler products that are simple and easy to understand and to acquire on behalf of our customers, that generate trust in the face of the offers of value posed by the insurance companies. And all of that aimed, among other purposes, to reach a higher coverage in insurance and also to advance in the very well-desired financial inclusion. We carry out this convention in one of the most complex situations globally and that we have had to face as a country and as a sector in several decades. Nevertheless, I'm fully convinced that the human team that the insurance company sector has, insurance sector has in Colombia with their high quality, is at the level of this challenge that we are facing in this new normality that is imposed after the crisis. We will overcome this situation hand in hand with our providers, clients, and intermediaries, hand in hand with the authorities, and proposing the government different alternatives leading for this sector that will allow them to act correctly before the situation that we are facing. We are striving for a better Colombia. We added to this situation, there is a convoluted situation in Colombia of difficult reading and with a high level of polarization that without a doubt requires a space for a serene and objective reflection. Dialogue between the different sectors is shown as the most promising path to advance towards a construction of a society that we all as Colombians desire. In the definition of that dialogue, the entrepreneurial sector of the country, especially the insurance sector, have to generate a space to help resolve the complex issues that we face as a nation. We should also become protagonists of the construction of the society that Colombia needs to face post-pandemic. And that way, we should join the development of the country to offer protection to the population at different levels that the insurance offers and to consolidate the reason for being of our activity. We cannot be less to this challenge. All of the Colombian entrepreneurship is important for the Colombia. As insurance companies, we are part of this collective of companies that we have to continue taking care of and promoting. From our role as insurance companies, we also have to contribute decisively on the growth of business fabric. The recent figures of DANE show that the country in 2019 had 5.9 million microbusinesses that occupied 8.3 million with sales of 669 million pesos. The contribution of SMEs registered before the Chambers of Commerce with the GDP was close to 45%. It is our small, middle-sized companies that generate over 80% of employment in our nation. So helping in the productive reactivation and to incorporate formality to those who are still not in it and to offer them financial protection, among other things, is a challenge that is left by this pandemic. The large companies that provide, especially those that provide insurance and financial aspects, we have understood for many years that sustainable management is core, not only to remain in the market, but also to grow in it as well. Responsible management and a sustainable management of companies is a mission that we have to participate in actively with an enthusiastic fashion. We are fully convinced that the only way to keep companies active and striving is that the environment that we are in should grow and should be developed in the same way. Our contribution as entrepreneurs to a fairer society that is inclusive is a contribution to our own survival and development. We recognize this symbiosis. We should not have companies without a society or society without companies. Consequentially, we cannot segregate companies, showing them as counterparts. On the contrary, We have to formulate dialogue to strengthen the adequate management of topics that are not common to us. Before the reality that we are immersed in, the agenda of this convention poses topics of special interest for our sector that we hope leave important evaluations for the time we live as all attendees. We cannot start this event without taking into account the person that has been present in our industry from different levels. The Board of Directors and FASECODA would like to make a special acknowledgement to William Fadul Vergara for his contribution to the development of the insurance industry, his human quality, his professional quality, and social quality, and commitment with this guild. So welcome to edition 2020 of the International Convention on Insurance, FASECODA, Colombia, a Safer Country. Thank you very much.